in Sicario, I think we learn a little bit about him. And I think here he's put in a situation in which we will learn more about the character, and we're going to put him in a totally different adventure where, in a way, he's got to reenact what caused his rage. The script was bigger, and by that I mean much more ambitious and a bigger scope than Sicario. So and unpredictable, which is always, he's very good at that. So that was exciting, you know. He creates great characters and got great dialogue. So that was exciting to get a script written by Taylor and a sequel. But personally, I thought that the character of Alejandro does have a different arc. Alejandro is able to perhaps relive in some ways what probably happened to his daughter. So that starts to create change something in him. And then, so Isabel being the daughter of a big cartel guy, maybe that starts to, that relationship of him being like reenacting what probably happened to his daughter with the daughter of a cartel leader, kind of opens a window of some kind of like, I don't know if it's compassion or he starts to have feelings, you know, towards the daughter of his enemy. He's flexible, which is good, you know. I think Jeffrey Donovan, Josh Brolin, and myself, we did these characters in the last film, so he's been very flexible to allow us to, be the interpreters of the characters and allow us to develop the characters in Soldado. It's a new mission. It's a new assignment, and I think that Alejandro has been in a on hold somehow, but Matt comes in and tells him we got another assignment. It's kind of like a new assignment, you know, the way I look at this story. But through that assignment, you know, a lot of things are revealed, and characters are emotionally, the characters are taken from here, from A to Z, really.